folks, Will from MinIO here with a how-to on listing objects on MinIO using the Go language. And in this video, we're going to be working with Go version 1.19. We're going to be connecting out to play.min.io to list some objects out of a Go demo bucket. And we're going to be running all of this out of Visual Studio Code. At the end of this video, you should be comfortable using the list objects function and also working with the list objects options struct, which is used to control how the list objects function works. You'll also see how to work with some of the results that you get back. Let's take a look at the code. So here we have our main package with our main function. I've got some simple imports here, including the MinIO Go libraries, as well as my MinIO demo functions. The MinIO demo functions is going to be called to run the play connect function, which is going to give me a MinIO client. It also sets up a bucket and some objects to work with. The bucket is called go demo bucket, and what I'm going to do next is I'm going to just run that list objects. Now, list objects takes a context. I'm just using a very simple context background here. It's got no interrupts, nothing like that. It just allows me to have a context. And then I also have this bucket name, as well as a very simple list object options, which I've set up to have no values in the struct right now. What's going to happen is I'm going to get back a chain of objects, and inside of there, I'm going to find my actual objects that are in my bucket. I've also set up a little print line here that's going to give me the name of the object, the e tag of the object, and the version ID of the object. My bucket is versioned, so we'll be able to see version IDs. So let's go ahead and run this with a go run. And what we get back is, well, there are two objects in my bucket, hello world text and an image PNG. Now, what may be interesting to you is that it's showing me the name and the e tag, but it isn't showing me a version ID right now. And that's because in order to see the version ID, I need to actually work with the list objects option struct. So right back up here on line 17, I'm going to go ahead and add in a version with versions. And I'm going to say that that is true. Now, there's lots of different things that you can add in here. If I wanted to have a few different list object options, there's lots of different ones that I can throw in here. I can throw in things like recursive. I can throw in prefixes and all that other fun stuff. Anything that I want to do to work with my object options, I can do here. So I'm just going to do the with versions for right now, though. Let's go ahead and run that. And if I run this one more time, what do I get back out? Well, now I get back out all the versions as well. And there's a few of them. There are a few of them out there. So all of these different versions are now available as part of my list objects. And that allows me to see all the details that I would like about any particular object in a bucket up on MinIO. I hope you've enjoyed this little how-to. If you'd like to reach out with us, you can use any of the methods you see here on the screen. You can chat with us interactively on slack.min.io, or you can just leave a comment here on the video. Thanks, and we'll see you for the next one.